largest city, Brisbane, as powerful floodwaters continue to sweep through the northern state of Queensland. About 20,000 homes and businesses are expected to be underwater by Thursday, when river levels are due to peak. Rob Minchin is a producer with the Australian Broadcasting Corporation. He's on the roof of his home in Brisbane.
The flooding has reached all the bottom tier of my house. It's chest height. I've got wild waves going through the house. I've got snakes in the house. My cars are locked in the garage. I can't get them out. They're floating around, banging in the garage. And now I'm just looking at a car floating past my house. I can see fridges floating past. I can see furniture, sofas. There's even been a report of a shark sighted in one of the local streets. A bull shark, and it was spotted in a local suburban street.
Sri Lanka is continuing its battle with floods that have affected about a million people in the east and central of the country. 18 people are known to have died. In the eastern province of Bactolo, there's been further heavy rain. Charles Haviland reports.
A Sri Lankan Deputy Minister, Mohammed Hizbullah, speaking from his town, Batticaloa, said the camps for displaced people there were growing by the hour. He said there was an urgent need for milk and infant food, mosquito nets, towels and sheets. Nearly 50 irrigation reservoirs have burst their banks, and the sluices of 5 more have been opened as a precaution. The chief local official said at least 15 villages were being supplied by motorboat via lagoons as roads were cut off.
The army has been deployed in the Tunisian capital after unrest over unemployment and poverty spread to the city. Soldiers with automatic weapons have taken up positions in the center of Tunis. Armored vehicles have been patrolling. Here's John Lyons.
A human rights activist contacted in Tunis said the situation was getting dramatically worse. She described how police quickly and violently broke up a demonstration of lawyers, artists and actors in the capital, beating the women particularly savagely. The activist said she